The Voyager Player software is located on the DVD that was included with your DVR. If you don't have the DVD, you can download the software from the ASA Electronics website. With the DVD inserted, or with the file downloaded, click setup.exe. You'll be given multiple install options. The one you want to choose is Install the Player. Click on that option. Go ahead and run through all the install options as needed. Click Finish to complete the installation. This will launch Voyager Player. For the login ID, enter admin. For the password, enter 1111. These are the default login settings and can be changed at any time in System Settings after logging in for the first time. The layout of the Voyager Player main window gives you an organized view of your DVR data. The top left of the screen is where you'll find any loaded video files that you may have. Whether stored on an SSD, USB flash drive, or SD card, you'll find all of your footage arranged by date and time within this window. To the right is the viewing area, the majority of the screen that's dedicated to viewing your DVR video data. What you see right now is a viewing area that is able to view 8 different channels, or cameras, at once. These icons here let you switch between a 1-channel view, a 4-channel view, or an 8-channel view. These two arrows here will let you switch between channels if only viewing one at a time. Just below the viewing area is the playback control bar. From here, you can open videos from an SSD, from any folder or directory on your computer, such as a USB flash drive, or from an SD card. You can also export any videos that you're viewing from an attached SSD. We'll cover more on this later. There are also play controls here, such as stop, play, pause, rewind, fast forward, step backward, and step forward. You can also go to previous clip, go to next clip. You can even take a snapshot or a still picture of the current video being played, and you can access system settings. Located below the playback control bar are the shock sensor readings. In the lower left of the screen are the GPS map, GPS info, vehicle speed, and trigger sensors. An example of a trigger sensor would be a turn signal, including which signal was used and when it was used. To access and load video files into the Voyager Player, select one of these three options on the playback control bar. If your video is on an attached SSD, click the Open SSD icon. If your video is in a folder on your computer or an attached USB flash drive, click the Open AVI icon. Browse and select the folder containing the video you want to view and click OK. If your video is on an SD card, click the Open SD icon. After selecting where to access the video files from, you will see the loaded files in the top left window, organized by date and time. To playback video, select the date you want to view by double-clicking or by selecting the plus symbol. With the date expanded, double-click on the time that you want to view. Video playback will begin immediately. Change the viewing area layout at any time with various camera view options seen here. Here you can get a better look at how the GPS data, along with the vehicle speed, function within the Voyager Player. If you are viewing DVR video from an SSD, you have the option of exporting video to save on your computer. The first thing you'll need to do is to determine where your exported video will be saved to on your machine. To set this up, click on the System Settings icon on the far right of your playback control bar. Find and click on the yellow folder icon. From within this browsing window, choose where you want your exported video files to save to, and click OK. Click Save to close out of System Settings. Next, make sure that your SSD video files are loaded by clicking on the Open SSD icon. Now click on the Export AVI from SSD icon. Within this window, select the starting and ending dates and times that you want to export video from. Below that are checkboxes that allow you to select which channels you want to export. Export one or all of your camera feeds as needed. Once you have everything selected that you want exported, click on the export icon. Once the footage has saved and the progress bar reaches 100%, a pop-up window will let you know that your video has saved successfully.